Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Yeah, all right. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, yesterday I talked about my former coworker Don, who wanted to put words next to text, and I came up with what I thought was the brilliant way to go of using the custom number format to get the word out there. The important thing was that Don did not want adding that word next to text to cause the formulas to change. He still wanted the number to appear in the formula. And you know, as I said yesterday, I could hear in Don's voice that he wasn't happy with this whole custom number format. It was just a little bit tough to do. So came up with this other idea, which Don liked a lot more. And I'm going to increase the height of all these cells. And then we're going to use something on the Insert tab. We're going to use a text box. Now, the text box used to be down on the drawing toolbar in Excel 2003. It's funny, it's now here twice. It's in the shapes as the very first one. They added that right before they went to market, and then it's also over here in the huge screaming icon. But for those of you who don't see it over here, you can always use the other one. So I'm going to add a text box. Oh, I get it. Okay, this one over here, this big screaming one, that's the one that doesn't work. Let's come back to shapes and use this one. There we go. Isn't that weird? I have no idea what was up with that. I'm going to draw a text box in here and, of course, type a word like approved. And now we're going to try and format this text box. So we have the text box, press Ctrl+1. And a couple of things, line color, we're going to say no lines, that way there's no line around the text box. And text box, vertical alignment, top, text direction, horizontal, that's great. We'll take the margins down to as little as we can. And looking for font, funny, don't see it. I wonder if we can just change it up here in the Home tab. There you go, nice, small text box. Now that the words are small, I can resize the text box, and let's see how it looks when we click away. There we go. The word appears, and you can't really tell that it is not part of the cell. Now, to copy that word, if you would need to do so, we're going to Ctrl+Drag, and we can make copies of the word. So you still have to do a little bit of adjustment there to try and get them in the same spot in the cell. But in general, it's good. Now, the real test here is, are those text boxes going to sort with the data? So I'll add a heading here and sales here, make those bold, and I'll try and sort this ascending or descending, sort and filter, smallest to largest, and the words did change. That's good. That's the default behavior of most objects. They move in size with cells. For me, this is a bit more tedious to go through and add the text box, get rid of the line, yada, yada, yada. I would have preferred the custom number format that we used yesterday. But whichever method works for you, have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.